first rule I've learned of business is called the potato chip rule. When I was in Chicago, Illinois, I was a junior account executive and then a senior account executive for Foot, Cone & Belding Advertising. We had Frito-Lay as our major account, and I worked on Frito-Lay. Learned a lot about chips. Here's what I learned that I've never forgotten. When you put a bunch of people who eat chips in a room, heavy users, heavy buyers of potato chips, you put them in a focus group. You know what I mean by focus group, right? Okay. You put them in a room, 12 of them, let's say, and you ask them the following two questions, you get the same answer every time. The first question is, do you like your potato chips heavy salt, medium salt, or light salt? What do you think they say? They say light salt every time. If you ask them if they like their chip heavy oil, medium oil, or light oil, what do you think they say? Light every time. If you blindfold them and you put a chip in their mouth, they will pick the saltiest and the oiliest chip every time. Every time. And the leading selling brands in the world are the saltiest and the oiliest. Lay's being the $600 million brand, for instance. Just that one brand alone. What's the point? It's a simple one, but one to remember. We are taught over and over when our lemonade stands as a kid, the customer is always right. The customer is always right in a customer service environment. But when it comes to new product development, growth initiatives, things that are gonna get you to another level, the customer's rarely right. You gotta know customers better than they know themselves. 55 used to be old. So I see that as when you just are starting to enter your peak performance years is 55. We're gonna have lots of people who are gonna see 75 as being middle age soon. Well, that's got everybody buzzing now. I think it's all the 55-year-olds, well, yeah, I've been telling you so. I wasn't going to tell this story, but since I got you on this one, I got to tell you this. I've been saying for years that you cannot pick up the front page section of any newspaper in this country and not have a gratification article in it. On Friday, did anybody read the US Today on Friday? I read everything. I read Wall Street Journal. I read the USA Today. USA Today, what's the name of the publisher, the founder? What's that guy's name? Al Newarth? You guys would know. Newarth? Newarth. Did anybody read his byline on Friday? His article is this. He's in a grocery store. He's shopping. He's with his four-year-old. He's in his 70s now. This is his child. He's got a four-year-old. That tells you something. He's in his 70s. He goes to the checkup line. They're checking out. They're scanning things. The four-year-old says to the lady, and it was the lady. That's what they said in the article. Some places, like in the country, lady's a derogatory term. Here in the South, we're okay with lady. They said in the article, the lady said, is this your diapers? And the four-year-old said, nope, those are dad's. Isn't that something? And here's the point of the article. Here's the point. This is going to be the attitude. People are going to say, yeah, I wear diapers, so what? Yeah, I can't see in here. What's your point? Baby boomers have never backed down from these things, and as they get into those years, I'll guarantee you they're going to fight back and say, yeah, I wear diapers. What brand do you use, okay?